Good afternoon, Reverend Sirs and everyone. Okay. 大家的法师还有各位居士，好，那各位禅修的，大家中午好。 Since today we don't have an interpreter, so I have to rack my brain basically to speak both languages. So, and it can be a challenge, especially after a whole day. 简单说，因为今天我们海乐法师他不在，好，然后所以呢，那个晚上呢，我要就是除了讲这个英文之外，我还要中文也是由我来讲，那肯定的就是这个不是那么顺畅，因为同时讲两个语言嘛，那我又不是语言，又不是语言天才，所以那就是多多包涵。OK。 I think maybe today I just like to begin to say a story first. Okay. My favorite story. People might be hear that for many times already, because since my favorite, so I should speak it again and again and again and again. 我说，首先我要先讲一个故事，那是我喜欢的一个故事。但是你肯定已经听了很多次了，但是因为是我喜欢的，所以很抱歉你还要再听。那。The story actually began with, the Buddhist text start like that. There was a monk, who liked to associate with the nuns. But please don't take me wrong, doesn't mean because associate with the nuns is wrong, okay? The story just start like that, I just follow the version, okay? And however, because of that, it creates so many kind of gossiping problem, okay? And then the monk, suggested this monk, the monk brothers suggested this monk, you don't have to associate the nuns too much, otherwise, it creates so many, dispute. And then this monk was very angry with that, the monk brother. And then these monk brothers, so, because since they could not persuade this monk, his name is called Bhagguna. He could not persuade this monk called Bhagguna. So, and then he would talk to the nuns, said that, it might be better not to associate to this monk so much, And then the nuns also get angry, and then they would just go to these monks, the brothers, monk brothers. And that's how actually it starts the story. Now, the 故事其实, 叫奇那莫尼, 奇那莫尼是一个比丘的名字, 这个比丘呢, 他因为喜欢跟那个 比丘尼常常在一起，反正就引起了很多是非，就对。所以呢，他的师兄们呢，就劝他不要常常跟这些比，就是在一起，因为引起很多是是非非。然后，但是这个比丘就很不高兴，反正就骂他们就是。那他们没有办法，他只能就是跟那些比丘尼讲，但是也遭到同样的一个对待。那比丘尼也是在骂这些比丘。好。So looks like because of that monk creates so many dispute. So, and it was told, then it was informed to the to the Buddha. So the Buddha called him, asking, a certain question. So, 当然这个事情发生，热闹也大了。最后呢，那只能就是找到，就是人家就智慧的这个佛陀，佛陀就找他过来了，就是这个叫做奇那摩尼这个比丘过来。And then the Buddha actually started to ask him, why you wanted to join this community? That means why you would become a monk, And then he said, because I want to be, certainly, be free from my mind, be, out of suffering, and that's why I joined the community. 那当然他的问答就说，就是我要让我自己没有，就是能解脱，没有烦恼嘛，所以我才来这样的僧团。 Then the Buddha, actually interesting is the text, the Buddha didn't continue to say this, anything, but I'll say that, then the Buddha started to tell a story. Okay. 那接下来的佛陀并没有立刻给他什么答案，也没有说他对还是不对，什么都没说，他就跟他讲了一个故事。 That's my favorite story comes by. 这个就是我的最喜欢的故事。 Why I say this is my favorite story, I learned this text. I mean, I read this text maybe two times, three times in those days. I never thought it's important. I don't like it. I just like, you know, what is this text about? You know. And of course, I respect all the texts. It's just like a text, you know. Fine, you know. There are so many powerful ones, like the Satipatthana, like about meditate on the, you know. I have a translation. I just translate, you know. The call about the meditation on the body, meditation on the mind, meditation on the feelings, meditation on the Dhamma, you know, all, and then you become Arahant. Those texts I love so much. You know. And and this text doesn't have become Arahant, so it's not important. 那么就是说，那就是我其实这个经呢，我也看了很多次，只是从来没有对它有什么特别感情。 那我一般以前喜欢的经，就是说，哦，到最后讲完这个经，哦，很多人就证你这个法眼开了，证了阿罗汉果啊，证了什么，这是我喜欢的经，只要没有提到证阿罗汉果的，我都把它放在一边啊，看了就算了。And so that's why I sometimes when people tell me something, I can definitely relate because I have much more experience than you about this. 就是有时候你们可能告诉我说，哦。 这个我喜欢这部经啊，那些经没什么意思的啦。啊，其实我觉得我这种经验也很多，因为我这个我以前就是每天一定要看经的，我睡觉前一定是要在看东西的啊，我有个习惯。Anyway, now the story is like this. The story said that there was a woman. She's very rich, very renowned, and very popular. And everybody said she's such a nice woman because she's so rich and beautiful. And elegant, you know, and very calm, very quiet, and very, very, you know, good sense. Usually in the original language, mean good sense, mean you're calm, looks bright, you know. And at that time, actually, there was, you know, in those days, even nowadays, the same in India, though when those rich women are so rich, they will have so many servants, right? And then one of the servants, the name is called Kalu, actually literally means the black servant. Maybe, I don't know, that's name, anyway, some people translate. So that's a servant. She said, she thought, you know, why this, when my host, when my master, this woman, are so famous, are so nice, it's all because of me. If without me, I mean, she would not be able to be such a nice, you know. 简单故事是这样,就是说, 我喜欢的故事是这个，就是说有个女的，她是非常贤妻，非常有钱，那么当然也长得很漂亮，那么就是大家所谓的这个贤妻良母这一类，然后当然又富有，那么当然你知道在印度这个富有的人呢，都一定有这个卑女嘛，那么有那个有一个卑女叫黑卑女，就黑奴，她的翻译叫黑奴，就是黑的卑女，就说就心里想说，如果其实她为什么这么有名，为什么人觉得她这么好？ So what she did is, actually, she decided the next day she would not work, she didn't wake up, okay? You know, in Indian tradition, or even nowadays, the same, when you're a servant, you have to wake up earlier than the master, right? Because you need to boil the water, prepare the hot water, you know, maybe prepare tea, all this sort of thing. And then the master, when she woke up, she didn't see anything happen like usual, and she's wondering what happened. Anyway, she went to the servant's the room and locked the door and went inside and asked, what happened to you? Are you not well? You know, what she did is she said, nothing. And she kept on asking, something wrong? Nothing. Okay, that's only her answer. And with a baffled mind, and his master left. Okay. 发生了什么事呢? 那么隔天呢, 当这个主人起来的时候, 看到他的婢女像以往这样, 本来要准备茶烧水, 都没有做, 他当然就觉得是不是发生什么事啊? 他就到了房间里面去一看, 他还在睡着, 他就问他, 有什么事情吗? 你还好吧? 他说, 没事, 没事。 你再问他, 你真的没有事吗? 没事, 没事。 这个我前面也听得很多, And then, the next day, I mean, of course, that's fine. The next day, unfortunately, the next day, and same thing happened. And this time, when she asked, what happened to you? Are you sure that you have no problem? Nothing. And then, Then she said, no, this should be something because this is not the usual you, right? And then she also didn't reply, the servant, say the same thing, just say nothing, nothing. And then she got angry. She suddenly scolded her, you know, maybe telling her, give her a big lecture or something like that. And she left the master. 那么当然呢, 第二天又同样的事情发生了，那么这个主人当然就问他为什么，他也同样回答说没事没事。到后来呢，他当然就很生气，就骂了他，甚至教训了他一顿，就离开了。Okay. Now the third day, when she woke up, the same thing happened. You know, imagine if it were you, what you would do? Maybe you bring the knife. Okay, but anyway. So, and she went in, she asked, are you sure you have nothing? And then, you have no problem? What happened with you? Are you sick? Are you not ill or what? She said, nothing, nothing. You know, and then she get really cross, you know. And then she just took, you know, in those days, beside the bed, they would have this needle and, you know, and the thread needle, because that's how their work, you know, part of their job. So she was so angry that, because this never happened to her in the life, right? And that happened suddenly. She was so angry that she took the needle and just somehow stepped on her head. And she got bleeding. You know, when angry came so much, she bleed. And then she ran away and told everybody, you see, my master hit me. Now I got blood, I'm bleeding. And then since then, this woman, everybody thinks she was a nice, calm, soft, beautiful, and it become notorious. Ah, a bad master. Mistreated this servant. Must be always abuse the servants, right? And that's how the Buddha end the story. No more. Okay. 那么这故事呢，接下来是说，他到第三天起来的时候，也一样，这个婢女也没有起来跟他准备什么东西。 他就到了房间问你发生什么事了、啊？他说没事没事。Of course， 他就变得非常生气了。然后呢，他就随手呢，在他旁船的旁边那些针线嘛，都有针线，古代人啊、哦，他就拿了那个针，就一刺就刺到他的头上，然后就头破血流啊，就流血了。然后这个婢女呢，就跑出去告诉大家说：“你看，我现在头血，我很痛苦，因为我被虐待了啊、哦。”所以从此呢，这个主人呢。 就变成恶名昭彰，哦，大家都知道，啊，他这个主人都不好了。And this is how the Buddha ends the story. And actually, the Buddha started to say something. I'm not going to talk that now. And why I want to say I like this story, because talk about my own experience when I was younger. You know, when I say younger, I mean when I was a monk, I was younger. Even when I was in Sri Lanka. I used to also have to help lots of monks living there, okay? But then afterward, there were so many things happened also, you know? And I was sometimes so busy, I didn't even have time to do my own thing. Sometimes I do, you know, it's not in like in America. Imagine even in America, such a clean place. You go out, you know, take a bus, maybe wait long time, but you have a bus, and nobody there in the bus. Always you can find a seat, right? You sit and then you go a place, you can have a beautiful view. But in Sri Lanka, the bus is always crowded, packed with the people. Packed, when I want to say packed, I mean there's no door, okay? The door is a human, okay? But the good thing in Sri Lanka is when you are taking a bus as a monk, you stand there, they have to let you to sit, okay? They cannot allow the monk to stand because it's, you know, it's religious reason, not very nice. So what happened is, if you stand there, the people had to go down. The main door, they would go down. Everybody go down, at least in the front seat. And the door who sit in the front seat had to stand up and let me to sit there. Sometimes I feel very embarrassed because imagine when I just stand in there, when the bus stop, everybody come down. And you sit there, you cannot imagine that kind of situation. Well, I want to say that one thing is that, and especially I feel very shy because I think, and However much I'm still a foreigner, I just feel it's not very good for them, right? So I had to wait until less people, at least the door doesn't, you don't see the people in the door. I only wave my hand that I needed this mask. Otherwise, sometimes I had to wait 1 hour. But in those days when I had to work, I mean, to helping people, just to find a teacher for them sometimes, you know, there's no telephone. It's very hard to get telephone. So you had to just travel. So that takes you a long time, you know. And also when you're inside the bus, because Sri Lankan people, they like to apply a kind of, what do you call this, coconut oil, you know. They always have coconut oil with the hair. The man used the coconut oil with this. The woman would be, you know, with different style. And then they also have a different kind of body smell. I think the worst thing to me, actually, not those. The worst thing is because they use very cheap perfume and strong. When you're in the past, you definitely will remember the Heart Sutra. Anyway. Now, 讲中文简单说就是我只是在说在斯里兰卡的在住的那个因为我要搬出很多人要做很多事情在那的时候然后呢有时候要出一个门呢对我来讲是相当困难的就很多困难就对那连一个坐一个巴士都要闻不同的味道啊那还有要等很久因为人太挤了那 anyway we know after you've done all these things, to find them a tutor, to help them to do, you know, to, in those days, because I was earlier among to be, as a foreigner who speaks Chinese, I was the earliest one. So to find tutor for them, and to make the notes, because their English is not that good, I always had to prepare the notes for them, and all these things. But you know, when people have trouble, they forget all these things you've done. Okay? They forget. And you make one mistake, it's enough. For example, there was a time a monk came to see me. He said, I was told that you have all these lecture notes because we type, you know, the past few years. Every time when we hear the lecture, we have a cassette, we have a typewriter. You know, we were so lucky to have a typewriter in those days. Here and then here again. We do that all the time because we just thought this is Dharma. We should be, you know, doing that. And now they came, they don't want to prepare. They just want our notes. That's fine. We also share the notes, copy, you know. They took it. They just say, thank you. That's fine. It's very easy. They take it. Fine. But the problem is one time the monk asked me, they say, I want a note. I say, I'm sorry, I don't have the note. Because people took it already. And some monk who took that notes, and they have a copy, if you want the notes, and I don't need that anymore, but why don't you ask them to take it? Somehow, I don't know why. Maybe he went to see the other monk didn't want to give the note or whatever. I don't know what. And maybe they miss, you know, something wrong in the language. Maybe like, you know, oh, I don't have the note. You ask the Dhammadipa, he had a note. You know, it could be, this human nature, right? So whatever reason, I don't know. And then he misunderstood that I didn't want to give him the note, okay? And this is how human nature is. And one other thing I find very funny is, you know, remember when I talk about the cassette? Even when you listen to the cassette, you know, and anyway, I don't want to say the story. Easier is that then because of that, and then people will start to say, oh, Dhammadipa is back, you know. He didn't give me the note. So he hide the note, okay.
Keep all the note for himself.
And 简单的说就是, 当初我要帮助很多人很多事嘛, 但是有一次有一个法师跟我借这个笔记本, 我们以前都是很难的真的是那个时代, 花了很多时间做了很多笔记，弄用打字机打了，反正他没有拿到，但是后来慢慢就是外面的传言说，就问我说，哎，这个看你不是这样的人啊，为什么他来跟你拿笔记本，你不给他笔记本？我说这笔记本都没有，已经借了给人家，我叫他去跟那个和尚他们拿就好，因为他们拿走了，我也不在意这个笔记本，因为我都根本不需要了，但是反正就是这样，这边要说明是你做了多么好的事情，你可能这件事情。 就算我是被冤枉的也好，但是呢，人家就认定你就是一个坏的。Now, of course, I get very angry. Actually, I'm not angry with the people, not monk. I was angry with myself. You know why? I was very angry because I thought, why I have to do this thing for them, right? What do I get? Nothing. You know, if I never told them I have a note, no problem already, right? Or even I just burn the notes. So, but when the notes was on there, and then why the people making this trouble? And of course, at the end, the trouble, I knew they were fighting with the notes already, because for them it's very important. With the notes, they can pass the examination, you know. And, but for me, I mean, that's what I, that time I was so angry. Actually, I was not very happy at that time. I was feeling myself like burning, almost like, I feel like I'm like a crab, you know. You know the crab, in a Chinese way, to cooking a crab, you know, the hot water there, pan, and then the crab pour, and then you just want to, I saw that. I just feel like I wanted to jump out, but I couldn't jump out. Really, that's really, really, you know, catch tension. I feel really, really furious, you know. And the worst thing usually when you get angry is not because of others, you get angry with yourself. So furious about myself, why I was so stupid, why I want to do this, why I want to do that, you know, that's the question. 简单的讲就是我那时候因为这件事情呢，我非常的生气。 我记得很清楚，我觉得我真的是在水深火热。那时候我讲了一个形容，就是说，我就感觉我自己像一个螃蟹一样，被抓着要丢到那个火锅里面要烫烧。我这样，但是想要逃出去就逃不出去，这样就是这样。因为我觉得其实人生里面呢，最困难的一件事就是有时候你就是你气你自己，而不是说因为你只是气别人。我是认为这样。Now, only after many years, when I read this text, I realized I was a fool. Okay, 就是过了很多年之后呢，当我再重新再读到这部经的时候，我才感觉，哎呀，我怎么这么笨呢？ You know, that experience has actually caused me a lot of pain, very painful sensation, and I lost my. Actually, there was a time I completely lost the faith to people. But this is just one incident. I just want to say one incident. And I also lost the faith to even, not the Dharma, but like even the monk brother, you know. I just don't know why. I couldn't understand that. But this story actually, when I read the story, I started to realize that, yeah, why I was so fool, you know. Do you get the message now? 简单说就是当我在重读这部经, 讲到这个故事的时候呢，我那时候心里突然间就了解了一个事情。我说，为什么过去我怎么这么笨？你们知道我在说什么吗？ Do you know what I was talking about? No. Now, just imagine the story turning another way. I am the master. And then that particular person is the servant. He's asking the note, okay? But the story is something like this. Actually, maybe easier to explain, don't have time now. It's when that person asked the note, actually I don't even know the story, you know? The story might be because this person had went to see the other monk already. Where is the note? And people told me that Dhamma Dibas, all these notes, it's in with you, right? But then that person told me, the other person may say, the B person say, no, we don't have that. I don't know. Go to ask Dhamma Dibha. So that's why he came to see me. Okay, it could be. Because he was having the wrong information. Then I direct him back there again. So, no, there's no nook here. The nook is over there. Okay. Now, I want to just say the story is complicated. I'm not sure. I don't want to know the fact now, but I just know one thing. Think about the story we just learned. The story say actually, if I always think like this, if the master, even though he's not a perfect person, he still get angry. But if he knows that, if she knows that, the servant's going to frame her, making a story, you know, and this master would treat her completely differently, right? How they would treat? Ah, how nice, what happened with you today? No, nothing. Oh, bye-bye. Tomorrow, what happened today? Nothing. Oh, bye-bye, right? If you know her plan. And the third day, what happened with you? Oh, bye-bye, come with me. And told her, you know, she's the most lazy servant. I want to kick her out. No, people think, why you're so wise? You can see she's so she's so lazy, right? Right. So that actually start to let me to think, I don't know, I cannot control other people. What happened there? But I must be able to control myself. This is the, that's how they give me the lesson. And I was, because of just a note reason, and I suffered for many years. When I think about it, I was very angry with them. Because how hard we work on the thing, and later on, become a topic for people to discuss, become a, it should be a good thing, become a bad thing, turn out in a different way, right? So, 讲回中文,就是说, 我说其实简单的说就是这个故事里面如果当初啊就是刚刚佛陀讲的故事呢如果那个主人呢知道这个悲女呢是要陷害她的时候呢他实际上只要对她好就好了到了第一天就问她她说没事没事好没事啊第二天没事没事好没事啊第三天没事没事就是说哎你跟我出来然后告诉大家你看这个人这么懒我要把他解用了啊把他卖给别人好了啊或怎么样对不对 大家都说哇，这个贤妻的妇女太有智慧了，是不是啊？对不对 ？Actually, the problem just came. 其实的问题只是在于什么？这个妇女她没有用正确的方式去对应这件事情而已。 In other words, mean actually the master didn't have the proper way. That's at least I look at it. Didn't have the proper way to deal with this matter. Okay. Now, okay. Now, then why we have to mention this? Because then the Buddha later said, you know, we have to be very, whenever we speak something, we have to be very careful. Because whenever we speak, we must always speak in the right time, right? And speak with a correct thing, that means the truth, not the lying. And you have to speak with what do you call that, with a meaningful thing, okay? And as well with a very soft, nice tone, you know? And as well with the last thing, with a good, loving kindness of mind, okay? But that also actually give me a sign to tell me that when people come to talk to you, you never know. People can come to talk to you with a evil mind, but with a soft tone, correct time. But even sometimes maybe truth, you know. The truth is, this is a fact, you know, it's a fact. So, and with the meaningful also, but with the evil mind. But of course, sometimes they can talk, tell you something, maybe actually with the nice mind, but with the wrong time, right? I'm sure you understand it with the wrong time. Like some joke, you know, we can be joke here, but if I want to joke some other people, for example, in the wrong time, the people get angry, you know. Right. 那么简单说后来佛陀在这部经下面呢说什么他就说其实我们人呢讲话的时候呢一定要讲要对的时间讲然后要讲真实的话要讲有意义的话那并且呢就是说要用这个柔软的语言跟要用这个慈悲的心去跟他讲话 但是这边呢也是告诉我们说当人家来跟我们说话的时候他不一定这个五个条件都会有的有的时候他可能是前面的四个条件都有但不一定有慈悲的心他可能听起来很柔软讲起来是事实对不对比如说什么东西呢我常常在经验上就知道有的事情是事实啊比如说我骂过那个人是一个事实 但是为什么我要骂那个人不知道对不对讲这样话对吧所以讲的是事实也是有就是说起来都有意思的啊但是心呢它其实是想让你知道它想让你对那个人有意见就是心不一定是慈悲的对不对所以 So that's the reason why actually that's one of the reason now when did I discover this the text again, yes, linked to my story yesterday. It was a time when I started about to go to England and when I lived there. Okay. You know, imagine, for so long, and that's how I realized that this text is so important. How could I just forget it in the past? Because this is nothing about Arahant. 简单说，我虽然我是到在英国的时候，我才再翻到这部经的时候，就是我才看到说，哎，怎么这部经以前读过了没有感觉？为什么现在才发觉它这么重要？ But actually, that really saved me a lot of things. 那么这个呢，其实呢，帮助非常大。 Sometimes when the people ask me a question, they say, you know, I have to deal with many people in their job, like a politician or people working for the government, you know. They ask me, they say, you know, I have to deal with so many people, what can I do? I never say what you should do. I only say that, you know, that's, I always tell them this story. And they always tell me later on, give me the feedback, say, thank you for your story. It's a marvelous story. Save me a lot of problems. 那么就是当然我也认识一些居士嘛，哦，那么也很多就是跟政治有关系的一些居士啊，就是说比较复杂的环境吧，应该说，他们来问我的时候都问说，哎呀，这些事情啊，这个烦恼啊，那个烦恼，我要怎么做啊？我常常就是我都不跟他讲怎么做，因为这个怎么做这个课题是一个不是三言两语可以说得清楚的，我常常就是跟他讲这个故事，讲完之后他就知道了，然后呢，他们在。 每次有时候写信给我也好，跟我见面也好，都跟我讲同样的话，就是很感谢我，这个告诉他这个故事，对。Now, actually, this story go on. Okay, I also want to pick up a little part. Then the Buddha mentioned this, and then after the Buddha also mentioned that the next part I taught yesterday, say about the earth, you know, shower of the earth.You know, like a river, you want to use a torch to want to dry the river. But anyway, those are the simile. But the last thing the Buddha say, you know, if you are the monk, the Buddha say, if you are a person who are a monk, you vow to be a monk free from the anger, wanted to be free from defilements, wanted to be enlightenment. But, you know, you should not have anger. And then this is how the Buddha say, what I taught yesterday also, and then your mind always must be always free from anger, okay? Free from himsa, I mean, wanted to hurt other people feeling. And then also, and then free from not happy actually means you have to be very happy, joy, kind of joyful mind. You must be able to have this few things.And then even, it's extreme case here, the Buddha said extreme case. Even when people using the saw, wanted to saw your limbs, you still do your loving kindness towards that person. Okay. 那么这个佛经接下来是怎么继续说呢？这个有趣哈。那么就讲到有四个譬喻，昨天我已经谈了，就不说了。那佛的最后就说我们心呢，应该要对众生呢，只要有，一定要有这个没有这个嗔恚，那么心要一定要不要有嗔恚，不要有这个害人的心，叫害心啊，害人心，也不要有这个不快乐的，一定要有意乐，我们叫意乐，中文叫要有这个心里要有快乐的那种状况。然后他说，甚至呢，就算人家拿一个锯子啊，要锯你的这个。解你的这个四个这个身体的时候，你都要跟他羞耻。Can you do that？ 你们可以做得到吗？如果是人家锯子要锯你身体，你都跟他愿你快乐。Actually, this question I was asked, you know, when I was once I was in went to a Jewish synagogue.And I was in the, anyway, I was invited to answer certain person's questions. And then the rabbi asked me the question is that, according to, you know, their religion, how they think, but he asked me, how about we think about the anger, you know? And I told him about this story. And he said, wow, Buddhism looks like a radical compassion? Radical. 简单的说，那个我一直到一个犹太教教堂去的时候，然后后来那犹太教的这种啊，我们他们叫 rabbi， 就像一个神父这样哈、啊，然后他们就犹太教这个教这个传教士，他就问我说，哎，我们这个在犹太教是怎么看待这个称谓这个称心的，啊，然后他就问我说佛教怎么说，我就跟他讲这个事，然后他说哦，看起来这个佛教的这个慈悲啊是叫做。叫什么极端的慈悲啊、哦，就是极端，就是在他翻译的极端的慈悲。So now I want to say this. There are actually the few meanings there. One thing, do remember whenever the people come to talk to you, you never know unless you can read their mind. You don't never know. Sometimes they might be makes you angry. Maybe they have with a good mind, but in the wrong time, you know, to spit something, right?那么有时候呢，当人家来跟你说一些东西的时候，告诉你的时候，可能他真的是善是一个慈心的、善意的，啊，慈心的，但是只不过在找错时间了，啊。Okay, for this, I also like to share you one recently experienced. The experience is this time when I was in Taiwan, I have a close friend, and close to me, I know that person a long time. I hardly spoken to him, but I know the person.And then the person had a little problem with their job, not because he couldn't find a job. It's always he changed job. He always had a fight with the boss. Okay. And that night I went to his house, particularly because after I hear this story, and I say, can you drive me to his house and see whether he's in the house? And he was in the house. Of course, he was very happy to receive me in the house. So I directly to tell him, I come here, I want to talk to you.And I tell him a lot of story. Actually, the problem is like this. I told him the story is like that. You know, why you have the problem? I know that you're very smart. You know your profession so well, you know. But whenever the boss asks you to do something, you always want to tell the boss your opinion. How the boss feel? And he said, oh, of course he doesn't. He would not be happy.And then I say, okay, then you know. What about the other? When the boss asks you to do something, okay, and then you tell the boss, don't worry, I will do it. Okay. What do you think the boss will feel? And they say, of course the boss will be happy. And I say, well, think about the next one. What if you told the boss, don't worry, I will do it, but you didn't do it properly, what the boss will say?And the boss will ask you, why didn't you finish the thing you tell me? And then, but at least, if you are a good person, you will finish the job, right? He said, yes, certainly I will finish the job. Okay. If you do that again and again and again, I mean, say that every time when the boss asks you to do something, you say, no worry, I will do it. At the end, if you tell, one day maybe you make a mistake, right? And then, people say, oh, this guy is not good. He doesn't do the job well. But the boss actually will say, no, 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 he always doing quite okay. It's just only this time he make a mistake. Am I right? Why the boss will be do this way? Why? Because the boss, whenever the boss need these people to help that time, he always give him the comfort, don't worry, I will do it. Of course he will do it, but sometimes maybe make a mistake.Then he would get what? The trust from the boss, right? But the problem I met so many people complain this to me in the life. They say, I'm so smart, I'm so good, but I hate my boss. And the boss hates me. That's the worst thing, the boss hates me. Whenever the boss asks you to do something, no, boss, this is wrong. You don't do this, you don't do that, you don't do this, okay? So, and especially when the boss have to go away,Phone, can you help me do this? No, I'm sorry, you know. How can you go away? You know, you should be here. Well, no. So, and then, you know, what happened? So what I want to say that is, then I just told him this story, and then it looks like I was told later on, he completely changed. But he had this problem for almost 30 years, because he's the same age of me.那我讲的这个事情故事是说，这一次我在台湾就有一个让我一个深刻的经验。 我一个居士，他在车上载我的时候，跟我谈起他的一个朋友，我都认识的。然后呢，这个经验是说什么？这个居士呢，就说到他的那个朋友，就是很好的一个朋友，就是太固执了。他的问题是什么呢？每次他都换了很多工作，但这个人是很聪明的，很会做他这个行业。我不想讲出来，要不然到时候有一天你要去做证，就是你就惨了啊！所以我不想讲做什么行业。然后呢，到最后他没办法，越做的行业越远啊，而且甚至到最后呢，发生什么样的事？就是薪水越来越少，又开车的距离更远，但是没办法，要养小孩子，养太太有什么办法啊？然后呢？我听了这个故事，知道因为我多少我认识他嘛，我知道他的性格。我说你带我到他家去，所以我就直接到他家去。然后那个晚上我直接就开门见山就告诉他这个事情。我就跟他说，当一个老板在叫你做一件事的时候，你如果都跟他讲提出你的意见的时候，老板是不会喜欢的，他承认这个。接下来就是说，当那个老板叫你做一件事的时候，你都说没有问题，我会处理的，老板一定就很高兴。因为他心里这个压力就没了，对不对？但是呢，可能呢，有时候在处理过程里面呢，你真的没有处理得好。那个时候很多人可能就甚至会站起来说话，说：“哎，这个人没有把这事情处理好。”但是当然他也做的好事，都有处理过。这个老板你会跟他讲啊，不不不不不，他这个可能这个一定会跟他说点话，对不对？为什么？因为刚才我已经讲了，这个很多人没抓到，就是因为老板最重要，当他叫你做一件事的时候，他就是要你帮忙嘛。转一个简单一点，你就用一个实心就帮他一个忙就好了嘛，是不是？理解吗 ？I know you don't speak Chinese, but you know， 理解吗？那 ，in other words, mean when you practice this meditation, don't just think that you do meditation. You know, when you are in the monastery, in the room, you know, in your special meditation room.May you be healthy and happy, you know. When the boss asks you, can you help me to do that? What? More job? Of course you don't say more job. You will start to say, no, I don't think that. Why don't you ask him to do? Why don't, right? Why don't you do this way? Why don't you just do this way first and I will do? Right? Your loving kindness gone. Right? 简单说就是不要再修这个慈悲啊、哦，很重要。不要说，哎，我现在就做这个，在这个佛堂做得很不错。回到家里面，可能自己还弄一个小房间，每天在做成。但是，一到工作的时候，一到外面的时候，老板叫你做事情，你就说，啊，为什么你不做呢？为什么你不叫他做呢？为什么你不？这个都是心里起的不快乐啊、哦，这些。你为什么不会用一个私心呢，来去对这个课题？而且。为什么这里谈到慈心也谈到悲心呢？因为呢，当你如果还有悲心的话，你也了解，当他叫你做一件事的时候，其实呢，就代表他是要求你帮个忙，对不对？事实上呢，你如果有这种时间，有这种能力，你要去用你的悲心来去帮他这个事情。人为什么其实就算是老板，他再怎么笨的老板，为什么有时候对员工会怎么？就是因为他看到这个人对于他的这种慈跟悲的心，了解吗？Just it sounds maybe a little unfair actually. This is my theory. It sounds maybe a little unfair, but why the boss sometimes like a certain person? I'm talking about in that case, because at least that moment, that person trying to show he has a compassion towards the boss. I will help you to do this. Okay. Now, when I say unfair, mean.Of course, the story, if you want to go on, you maybe say, no, that person, even though he was telling the boss, I will help you to do, you know. But just in front of the boss, he had the compassion. But with the other, he might not have. That's his own problem. But I'm talking about the boss and the person, you know, the relationship. It's such a common thing in the human is always actually,Unfortunately, there's a static research also. They call it as an emotion. I don't think that it's called emotion. Unfortunately, it means actually in our human, we all recognize that when the people treat you with compassion and treat you with loving kindness, you've always been appreciated. 我只是要说明这件事，不是在说这个人呢，他一定下面呢，他真的会做好事，哦，他可能只是在老板面前假装，也有可能。但我只是要说明这个是说，这个代表一个事实，就是每一个人一定是共同点，都是希望人家对他有慈心，更有悲心的。Okay. In other words, mean no matter the person talk to you, whether with what kind of mind.On an extreme case, maybe trying to make you in trouble, or maybe because he speak in the wrong time, or maybe he didn't tell anything true, is lying, he was just lying, he lied to you, or he actually said something very unmeaningful, right? However, if you always just respond with the loving kindness mind and compassion mind, you are out of the problem. 那简单说这里也换句话说，如果呢，不管这个人呢，他是跟你讲这话的时候是用什么样的心，就是可能他是其实他本来是好心，但是在不对的时间讲，哦，可能就是叫什么，可能就是骗你的，也可能是就是说讲一些没什么意义的话的。最后来讲，就是说我们有五个嘛，对不对？或者还有一个是什么？不对时间的讲，我讲的好。还有一个是什么？不是没对的。就是一个没有痴心，一个不对时间、不对时，一个是没有意义的话，一个是不讲真实的话，哦，或者他语言里面很粗鲁，好，哦，啊，或者很柔软。不管他是怎么样。但是呢，你如果都是只有对他以慈心的话，你是永远就是解决问题的。Okay. So, when you practice loving kindness and compassion, remember that. So, actually, your most powerful weapon, if there's, when I say weapon, I mean to help yourself, defend yourself, not to show your stern face, not to say no, 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 okay?But always with the loving kindness and compassion. Actually, those are the most powerful protection also for you. Why I want to mention this, we just today in the room, you know, in the Q&A room, we just say that, you know, in here, you can say something openly, but when you go to outside society, you've got to be careful, right? Because everybody trying to take advantage. That's how the competition is about. Right? But, I mean, we can recognize the competition, but the mind are very complicated. It's not very easy to deal with. So, only when you have a loving kindness and compassionate mind. So I think you are really can be put off a lot of trouble. I want to give this example to you because the boss is just one of the example. So,you find that to understand this practice and this kind of loving kindness or compassion or joy or equanimity, how important they are. Because that sometimes it can save you, you know, from trouble. I mean, the trouble not because people giving you, you yourself give you trouble. Imagine that if that guy, well, I just say that, if he realized this 30 years ago, he could be so rich,so happy now with his talent. Everybody love him, the way they look at him, like him. And even some say, you know, do you want to be something? And he said, no, why should I? So basically everybody love him. But he also told me that, yeah, actually, you know, everybody, when I just appoint a job, every boss first liked me. But then I started to almost complain, always complain, always complain.The hatred, you know, the mind, and just carry on. So, 我要讲就是说，想一想，如果刚刚那个故事哈，要告诉你说，我们修这个方法哈，有时候呢，修行的时候呢，要自己要知道，人要用在这个世间里面啊，这个才是真正修行的目的了。那么呢，就像那个刚才我讲的那个事情，如果那个先生哈，他在30年前他都懂这个道理的时候。我可以担保他现在非常的有钱，而且非常的真的就是 做什么事都没有什么问题，不像他现在还要很辛苦，而且是三十年的痛苦，就是那么一个东西而已。So when you think about that, the 30 years suffering is just because of one thing. Okay. Me, I have the same problem. Back to my story, right? My problem is that actually my suffering and those at that time, yeah, I'm fine. When I say I'm fine, I mean I can just put that aside. But it's still in my mind. I knew that. So, but why it was in my mind, I still couldn't understand why I have to do this thing for the people. But now I know, after when I read the text, I know. It was not his problem. Because these people, they definitely have that problem. Why? Even I trapped in that problem. Okay. Of course, if I trap in the problem, that means if I think I'm smart, I'm not smarter than them. They can trap in other problem, and I can trap in this even unnecessary problem, I think. Yeah. 那么回答来就是说，就像我刚才讲那个故事，我自己的说，那虽然这件事情我不想他也没事，但是有时候想他，我以前真的很气，觉得我这么辛辛苦苦为你们找老师做这个做那个，得到来就是一件事情，那有一个人就对我有意见，但他其实没有对我有什么意见，说老师了。但是我已经对我来影响很大，而且没有必要的事，然后我那时候真的是对人觉得说你有什么必要，没有那个必要，但是呢，刚刚我说了，我讲英文的时候我讲，就是我事实上那时候后来就当我看到这部经，我立刻理解到这个时候，我说当然了，他们都会有这种问题，怎么可能没有呢？连我自己都被绑在这里面，混在那里面，痛苦了这么久。虽然我自己以为我没有这个痛苦，把它忘记了，但是事实上它对我影响，对人的看待方式还是一直影响嘛，对不对？就是我看待人都是用的方法说，说我干嘛要帮你啊？我干嘛要跟你做啊？我干嘛要这样？对，是吧？因为我还是没有看清楚这个事情呢、啊。对 ，In other words, I mean, I still didn't see through that, you know, that the cause and why and what I should do, and what is the fact.What is really is a dharma. So that's why sometimes I was thinking, why I have to help you? You know, because with my past experience, it doesn't do anything good to me. Okay. All right. I'm so glad time's almost up. Before that, I promised to say a few things. One thing I want to say is that usually we must understandIn the Buddhist perspective of anger, we have different terms for anger. And for example, we have the term called krodha, you know, and then we have the term ubanaha, pradasa, the three terms describe anger. 我要说我们在佛教里面呢，我们有三个词。其实我们一共有四个，一共有五个词，但是基本上我们先讲三个哈，来形容嗔恚这个东西。那么 the first one when we say somebody anger as a krodha original language, so in Chinese called 愤恨的愤，愤愤怒的愤。It refer to normally when we get angry is when the situation comes along, but you suddenly get almost like heat and you get anger, you respond very quickly.Just like when you walk on the street, for example, somebody bumped to you. You say, what you are doing, right? But sometimes you just forget it, and you do your job, right? But that's called, actually you're angry. You know, what are you doing? You just, you know, push that person back and you just walk, right? However, if you hold on that, you are thinking, why that person hit bumped to me today? I must be unlucky today. I'm going to see a very important interview.So you get more angry, right? Because you hold on that. So what happened? Your physical sensation come to burning, and burning, and burning, and on your chest especially. This is where we have the term called ubanaha. Okay? In Chinese it's called nao, hen 起来了。Now, if you still hold on that, because you have to subdue it, you don't want to show in the interview that you're angry. Otherwise, you will not get a job, right? What you do, you just hold on it, but you still hate that person. Especially if you didn't get a job, okay? That's because that I was unlucky, that people bump on me, and then, So what happened? You have another term comes called a pratasa, okay? Actually, in Chinese, called now. How now? Now, okay? But in this tree, according to the Buddhism, the worst one is the last one. Because it was just like what? Just like something tickling, you know, like a thorn tickling on your whole body. The more you think about, the more you get. So the longer you hold it, the longer you get angry. Don't you have this experience in the past? Right? So this is also explain why. Some people, when they don't understand this part, at least this is a Buddhist psychology, if they don't understand this part, some people think that, you know, when you get angry, you should be like... sulky, you know? And then, actually, you have come to the second, right? And unfortunately, if anybody who are weaker than you, come. Pap. Unfortunately, that happened to a parent sometime also. And after that, they say, oh, sorry. But anyway, I soon lose my face, so why are you here? Go.我只是大概是说，那么佛教里面嗔恚啊，分三个层次啊来说哈。第一个呢，我们中文叫做禅宗要去注意这个，就是愤恨的愤。第二个我们叫恨，第三个叫恼啊。愤一般来说呢，就是东西发生的时候你不高兴，但是呢，如果你一把它发泄出来，它就没事。但是如果你继续呢把这件事情呢，这件事情哈，还是把它。 抓着不放的话，就是贪呐，啊，抓着不放的话，贪的话，那么会怎么样呢？他就变成一种恨，恨呢，你就越想越气，那个心里就好像被火烧，凶着就在烧，好。但是如果这个东西有时候呢，因为你可能因为对方的势力比你大，或者什么原因你不好发作，你就把它藏在那里面，啊，就一直想着这个人讨厌，不好，怎么样怎么，对，或者什么事情他为什么要这样，好，那这样呢？ 就变成什么叫恼懊恼的恼，好、哦，那么这个在原文的梵文也好，巴利文也好是不同的字来的，哦，那但是这个第三个呢，它是个最麻烦的，为什么呢？因为只有这个第三个呢，或者第二个也是，但是第三个它最麻烦了，因为它缠了很久了，所以呢，它变成在缠下去久的时候，它就变成我们后来讲的另外有个字叫做 viabada，OK，就是。 但第四个就是我们所谓的，我们中文一般把它翻译成 high， 你就会有这个 high 心，意思就是说你已经很气了，很闷了，所以呢，如果刚好尤其那个人比你弱势的，你就会欺负他，过来打他一巴掌啊，或者欺负他一下，那么就会有这个 high 心，那就是第十个就出现。但是为什么出现第十个？就是因为这第三个那个恨的东西一直藏在里面。 那你会对待人的方法会这样子对待的时候呢，都是用回什么样的方式，都会用人家怎么对待你，你就用回怎么对待他，因为你没有办法对那个可能你认为他比你强的人发泄，懂吗？嗯，所以换句话说，在佛家来说，其实有时候啊，当人家不小心触犯到你，你还骂他一句，哎，你干嘛讲？哎呀，就没事的，反而还好，最怕的反而是不出声。 当然我不是叫你们的哈，就随便就骂人的，不是这个意思哈。<笑>我是说，最怕是不出声，它就一直放在心里面，就恨在那里面，然后就形成了一个很大的一种。当然我们中文可能说法就叫怨气了啊。但是在佛教的这个词句的分别呢，那么就是变成有个害意就存在。那当然害意的出现呢，一定先就是我们的这个恼心出来，恼心呢。 恼的这个它是一种嗔恨来的，恼呢，就是恼火嘛，广东话有个恼火哈、哦，那么这种呢，他的感觉就是整个人就被刺一样，所以你要非得发作不可。 当我们有愤恨的时候，那个恨心出来的时候，感觉就像被烧一样，你就啊这样啊、哦，对。但是你会隐藏，你当然把它隐藏的好。但是这个里面的这个动作是一样的。OK。那么，那最后我要说，先讲完这个，我最后讲说，所以其实当你有学到慈心跟悲心的时候啊，你慢慢的会注意到啊，一个人在有慈心，常常能有就有啊、哦。当然有时候也会忘掉，或者我们叫做没有正念的时候，试念的时候，试念不是那个不是爱情那个试念哈、哦，试掉正念的时候呢。你可能没有，但是无论如何呢，至少我们现在有这个机会的，让自己能展演就让它展演，能持久的让它持久，能出现的让它出现的话呢，你会发觉这个呢就慢慢的就会被消除啊。当然而且你也会发觉从此呢，就是说有这种现象呢，你也会注意得到了，对啊。那么你就发觉我今天在这边讲的不是在跟你谈一个故事，事实上呢这个是每个人就是可以亲身经验得到，这也是我们为什么说在学法里面呢，法的重要、哦、法的重要就是这样，法就是这个特色，你就看到这就是法了，因为你看得到是这样子的。而且呢在这里面呢也慢慢你会发觉，除了这个嗔心不见了之外呢，当它淡的时候，你就知道原来我们就是贪执取才会有嗔。所以为什么有四无量心修得多的人呢，自然他呢也慢慢的脱落。怎么说呢？刚才我说了嘛，如果刚开始那个人如果他撞到你的时候或者对你不好的时候，你可能有慈悲心，愿你快乐就没事了，对不对？或者是说哎呀你还好吧，你没事吧，对不对？也没事啦，是不是？但或者是说我们的众生一般的烦恼的反应就是，又这个时候你就跟他抵抗了一下，可能你就忘了也没事，对不对？就是我刚才讲的那个，就是愤一下子就没事，他就是打了你一下你就打回他一下你就走了也没事。但是如果你一直把他执着，听着，执起这件事情发生过去了，没有存在的，但是执起呢，那个人干嘛讲我一句我不喜欢听的话哦，那么越想越气，那个就愤就起来了，对不对？累积的久呢，累积的久呢就怎么样，就不是恨，就是恨就起来，累积的久呢就懊恼起来了，懊恼起来没办法发泄的时候就想害人了，因为你不敢找不到他了嘛，也没办法跟他下手了，或者是也不敢跟他下手，对不对？那你怎么样，那你就会去害别人，因为你认为你是被这样受伤害的，所以你要用同样的方式去让人家这样子。 OK。但是你如果能化解这个呢，我现在说回你就是有慈心的话，当下你先化解，但是你修的慈心久的人呢，你就看到原来你的执取你的贪就贪在这些，当然总归来讲就是无明了，贪在这些事情上面抓着他不放，所以呢就害得你痛苦痛苦痛苦的一再而再。 OK and I forget the English already, but the last thing I just want to sayThat also show if you attach to the thing that in the past, something had gone in the past, that might cause you to anger at first. But if you can see this attachment, how you can see the attachment is mainly because when you have a loving kindness mind, when you check that again, you find, oh, it was because I might attach to that. That's caused me to hold on this thing, and that's how I have this view.And that's how I get angry again. Okay. In other words, mean, I also like to think that most of the time, not all the time, but most of the time, if any person, when they practice Buddhism, they don't try to subdue the anger, it is very hard for them to see the attachment. Because the anger is almost like a smoke. When there's anger, there's a fire, the smoke.Cover you, you don't see clearly what is attachment. And all, lots of people, when they talk about attachment, without removing the anger, it's just a concept. Okay? Only when your mind is, because everybody, when they have a focused mind and samadhi mind, anger will be there, not there, sorry, anger will be subdued. And that's why it's believed that when people have the samadhi, and particularly when you practice this method, So you subdue the anger. So it's very easy, the next step that you see the attachment. 那最后我要说，这就是为什么我们佛教有这么说哈。我们一个修定的人，有定的人呢，就很容易，就是有三昧的人，有三摩定的人，有三摩地的这种，有三昧定的人哈，就是才会有智慧生长，就会看到贪。为什么呢？因为当你有定的时候呢，嗔会被压下来了。那么当有贪起来的时候，就像我刚才举的例子一样哈，你就看得到。要不然的话，当你嗔恚还在的时候呢，你所谓说你能断到那个贪呢，都是一种在语言上打转的，不是真实的。Okay? 当然，尤其你在修四无量心，当然我不只是四无量心，因为定可以从有不同的方法来修得到。但是呢，尤其是四无量心，因为它是针对嗔恚来修的，它的对治，所以特别有效。换句话说，如果人家问你一个问题，说：“哎，修四无量心的人。”就只是叫你 happy happy 哦，开心开心，好吗？就这样吗？不只是这样，事实上呢，你再继续修，慢慢你会看到你自己的贪是如何升起的。这个就是接下来的一个阶段的，这个当然很重要了。看到贪的升起，当然也就是你容易断烦恼的时候了，是不是 ？So the last one I want to say, of course, if you're able to see how the attachment comes by.Cling on to your mind, and of course, then you will be able to see what is the cause of the suffering, right? In other words, when you can see that why the attachment comes, so then you'll be able to remove the attachment. Of course, the liberation would be not very far from you. So I want to say this, this technique has many, many useful things, but you have to practice.Every day, every minute. 那么就是这个其实方法不要看得那么简单。如果你真的好好的会利用的发挥它的时候呢，在你每分每时它对你的生命是很大的作用的。那么当然可能连断烦恼都有可能的。当然你只是把它当成一个修行的东西在这样修也是有帮忙，但是你就把它好像一个宝贝塞到一个柜子里面，每天就看了两眼而已。好，对，如果你真的会利用它的时候，就像我刚才讲的，帮你把嗔可以压除的时候，也就容易看到贪是如何的，所以那么断贪这个机会就会有了。 OK, we should have 10 minutes break. Thank you for your attention and forgive my English. And 很抱歉我的中文也讲中文讲英文，那么很谢谢你们的这个在场。谢谢，好，阿弥陀佛。